Hey guys, Mike Barilla from Tracy Rifle and Pistol here today. I got Rich Nance, Guns and Ammo, Personal Defense TV, WarTax EQC, bunch of stuff. He's an awesome resource to have. And then I got my buddy Bob here. So we're going to go over some underutilized techniques and muzzle strikes. So Rich, take it away.
Sure. Mike, people might wonder, why the heck would you strike someone with the muzzle of your gun? Well, the reason you may do that is because the quarters may be so tight that that becomes a very valid option. I mean, this is basically a pound and a half hammer. I mean, you can use this to your advantage. Now, when would you deliver a muzzle strike? There's a couple situations that come to mind immediately. One is when your weapon has malfunctioned or you've run out of ammunition. In that case, you might as well make use of this. Another time may be that the bad guy is reaching for the gun or has already grabbed the gun and you're going to drive it into him as part of your weapon retention technique. But let's look at actually striking with the gun and how we can best do that. We consider these muzzle strikes because we often use this portion of the gun to strike. And that makes a lot of sense. I've actually seen a self-defense DVD where the instructor was highly skilled, except that he was striking in this manner. And even if this weapon has malfunctioned, you don't want to create a habit of holding the gun like this and striking where the muzzle is facing you. It's just a horrible idea. So always want to maintain the muzzle oriented to the threat. And another consideration is, even if you think this weapon's malfunctioned, there's always a chance that it's going to go off. So you want the muzzle aimed at the bad guy, not yourself. Let's look at a two-handed muzzle strike first here. So what I'm doing, maybe as he closes distance, I try to bring the gun in, but it turns out a situation where I decide to strike him. I'm driving in and striking him just like this. Where's the most effective striking area? The face. I can do that by striking here, and I'm going to retract that too. I'm not going to hold it out here for him to be able to grab hold of. So it's just a quick strike. Notice I'm not just doing this with my upper body. I'm driving into him there and striking. You can do that with one hand as well. And you'll notice with one hand, it's not that different than a punch, right? My hand still rotates a little bit just like this. My other hand is still up here to protect. So it's just like that. Now, what if you want to strike with a different portion of the gun? This is also a good striking surface. As you can see, that can get the job done as well. You have to be careful as you're retracting this. Watch, this is what you do not do. See how that muzzle sweeps across my head? Not a good thing. But you can see just doing this isn't going to be powerful enough. So you are going to need to retract this, okay, and come down with the strike there. People may want to use this surface, and that may be okay. But what may tend to happen is as that hits there, that gun can be pulled right out of my hand. And the longer the muzzle, sort of the more likely that is to happen. So that is a consideration. So if you're going to strike with the muzzle, two hand, one hand, or with the bottom of the magazine, it's a good skill set to have. Do it fast, do it hard, and make sure you retract that gun as fast as you drive it out.
As always, Rich, thanks for coming by. Thanks for the tips. It's very useful to add that info to your repertoire. I mean, as a CCW holder or just as a police officer or anything else, you have to have tools for different situations. So thanks again for watching. Subscribe to us on here. Check us out at facebook.com/TracyRAP. And please check out firearmspolicy.org. They're working hard to preserve your rights.
Thanks, Bob.